Hi there, and today I'm going to be discussing the genre in relation to mise-en-scène of this film, Kill List. There are many genre types which can be discussed in relation to this film. For example, kitchen sink drama, thriller, horror and drama, and death cult horror. As the film progresses, all of these genres are shown throughout. The first genre that is shown is a kitchen sink drama. The film starts off as a kitchen sink drama. By this I mean it's a genre that is shown to represent reality in England. It depicts the reality of working class Britons living in cramped accommodation in the 1950s and 1960s. In this story of Kill List, the main characters Jay and Gal used to be in the military together. Now they are hitmen. They are hitmen because of the money situation not being as good as it used to be, which also connotes kitchen sink drama aspect of money. And that you would do anything to keep your family safe in locations like this. In terms of the mise-en-scène of the opening scene of this film, it shows Jay and his girlfriend arguing about money and arguing about the items he has brought at the supermarket. The bags on the kitchen table, as well as the full aspects of the kitchen, including the sink and the cooker and the microwave and the calendar on the fridge. This can connote kitchen sink drama because it shows realism. Shots such as this medium shot of Jay and Gal on the sofa with their wives laughing can also show connotations of kitchen sink drama, as well as a scene where they are shouting and throwing things across the table. The fact that they also have a sweet innocent child can also connote kitchen sink realism, as all of this is going on in the background without the child knowing about any of their parents' past. Another genre that can be discussed throughout this film is thriller slash hitman thriller. This is shown in the mise-en-scène of most of the scenes in this film, as there are scenes of money as well as reaction shots to the money and how the money can change their lives. Another medium shot of Jay and Gal waiting outside a building for Jay to kick the door open can also show mystery as well as a sense of thriller and horror. The more things which add to the mise-en-scène of the hitman thriller genre are scenes where Jay and Gal are holding guns with white gloves so that they don't leave any DNA on where they are killing people. Another scene where the mise-en-scène adds to the genre of thriller is this worm's eye view shot of Jay walking through an abandoned field towards the camera. This puts the audience in a place of vulnerability, which adds the feeling of him being a hitman. The costumes of suits and other expensive clothes while they are walking through posh hotels and posh housing estates also adds to the mise-en-scène of a hitman thriller. Another scene which establishes the hitman thriller genre is where they are putting the body bag into the car. It is a bird's eye view shot. Another genre that can be established in this film is horror. A scene that establishes the horror genre is a scene where the hitmen Jay and Gal are burning bodies on a fire. It is an over-the-shoulder shot which represents that someone is watching them. Another scene that represents horror is where they have been set the task of killing someone. It turns out that when they go to kill this person, they are part of a KKK-esque tribe that burn people at the stake. You know this by them standing around a wooden stand and then hanging someone on it and burning them. As you can see in the mise-en-scène of this scene, they have pitchforks and straw masks on and barely clothed as they walk past the camera. This can contribute to the mise-en-scène of the horror genre, as it is quite scary for the audience. You also don't know who these people are, as they are masked. The ending scenes, where everyone is wearing these masks, can be seen as a collaboration of genres including thriller, cult, horror, crime, and death cult horror. The ending scene where the tribe comes to the house where he is staying is a very important scene to discuss in terms of the mise-en-scène. There is a scene at the beginning of the film where Jay, his wife, and his child are playing with toy swords that he bought at the supermarket. Jay's child is on Jay's wife's back. They are playing with plastic swords. At the end of the film, he is put in a ring by the tribe to kill a hunchback, which turns out to be his wife and son on the back. There are many semiotic meanings that can be applied to this. Semiotic meanings including that a man would do anything for money. But there's also binary opposites here, as he is trying to protect his family, but at the same time he kills his son. It shows that he has become greedy in the fact that he would kill anyone for any money, even if he doesn't know who they are. He also discovers that Gal's wife, as well as his wife, are also in the cult, which reveals a mystery genre in that you don't know who people are. The fact that Jay's wife, Shell, draws a symbol of the cult on the back of the mirror in the bedrooms can show signs of the horror genre. Now I'm going to talk about some semiotics of the film Kill List. There is a mystery throughout the film about what Jay and Gal went through in Kiev. It can be seen as a dark cloud over their shoulders. When Gal says, "At least we're not killing a toddler," this could show connotations that this happened back in Kiev. When Fiona sees Jay's outburst at the dinner party, she scratches markings into the back of a mirror to show that Jay is the chosen one. This marking is of the cult. The full movie can be seen as Jay's transformation into the Antichrist by sacrificing the victims. He kills Gal, the librarian, and the people who help the librarian, as well as killing his child and his wife. At the end of the film, the hunchback scene, he kills his wife and son. They are the final sacrifice. He then becomes the cult's Antichrist by sacrificing the ultimate sacrifice. Well earned. At the end, when Shell takes off the white robes, she laughs in his face. This could be seen as irony. The boss could be seen as contracting Jay to find the leader of his cult. When he cuts Jay's hand in this scene, it's seen as bonding by blood to make him a leader. Another scene where Jay could be seen as the Antichrist is this scene, where he is in a restaurant with Gal, and he shouts at the Christians to play the guitar. This could show him being faithless and telling them there is not a good place for them in the world, and no one will be able to find them. This brings the Antichrist semiotics and symbolism into perspective. Sometimes.